Hey, this is Sean. What is going on? Let's see. A lot of toxicity today on the YouTubes, as far as dungeon masters are concerned. A lot of them are the banes of our existence in the hobby. Okay, so YouTube. Put this in my suggested viewing. I don't, what is that called in YouTube? Trend, not trending. What is it called? Just suggested things you might be interested in. I'm kind of interested in Traveler 5 in a way, sort of. This is Venture S Satchel, and he bought the three books. The three hardcover. I was talking about this, I think last night in a video. But he bought the three books. I bought the three books only because my artwork was wrapped around the book. I thought, you know what? I'll buy it just for that. But yeah, you pull off the wrapper and then you just have the three books there. And this guy did five videos. I didn't know, but a year ago he did five videos. He's using the Mythic GM emulator, is that what it's called? To do like a solo play of Traveler 5. I guess it can be done. It's the slowest. Traveler 5 is the slowest science fiction RPG out there to play. It's a snail's pace going through the rules just to run a game. I mean, technically, Traveler 5 is it's your typical generic role-playing system for making your own role-playing game, be it sci-fi, fantasy, whatever. It kind of tilts on the sci-fi edge of space. But if you're like me and psionics is magic, then you have magic in your game. Voila. Problem solved. Now, these are three books. Each of these books is 300 and some pages, close to 400 pages each. And I'll just pick a random one. Let's pick a random one.
Sorry. Half our education of six or three. No dice. Six beats the training analog of education.
So he's rolling up a character, and you have education. You do your education if you want. Yipes. And I like all the charts. It's like going through a service manual for an old North Star Horizon computer from 1978. An RPG that reads like an operations manual for a home-built S100 bus, a CPM computer that runs BASIC and it has a tape drive. Yeah. Here's pick another one. See what's happening here.
Value rules, snack, meal, clothes, device, major.
Now, this is the economy of Traveler 5.
Major part, ATV, large vehicle, small craft, starship. A buyer.
Everything has a scale in Traveler 5, like a size comparison. So here's a size comparison for value. Something of a value 1 is a snack. Clothes is a value of 2. A large vehicle is a 6. So these are like shortcuts, like ranges, band ranges. So if something's in this range, it's going to be, you know, something small. Something in this range is going to be something that you see on the horizon. You know, that's how much value the thing has. Is if you can see it on your horizon, if you can see it out there causing a tidal wave, a tsunami coming towards your little seaport village, it must have great value if you can see it that far away, causing that much havoc in the ocean as it bores into the center of the planet's core, ignoring what's nearby, kind of a thing. Let's see, what else we got? What's another thing we can talk? Characters, characterizations.
Also identified by its position in the UPP using the letter C characteristic followed by 1 through 6. To avoid confusion between a word's ordinary meaning and its use as a characteristic, such as capital S strength and little s strength, a character may be.
Down here's this little chart here. This chart appears everywhere in the book. So you got these tests you can do when you roll dice if you're trying to do something. So if something's easy to do, you roll 1d6 and you try to roll underneath your characteristic value, like strength or endurance or dexterity. A regular check would be rolling 2 dice, you know, equal or under your characteristic, and a hard check, you know, when something's hard to do, you try to roll 3d6 underneath your characteristic. And to make a test hard in Traveler 5, you just keep adding dice to the guy's die roll. So like a 7d6 roll would be, you know, pretty impossible. But then, you know, besides the characteristic, you're adding modifiers to the characteristic value, and you're adding your, situation. Are you being helped by anyone? Is it good weather, bad weather? You know, these kinds of modifiers get added. So you're not just basing things on just your characteristic alone. What else we got here?
Then every easy check I pass with flying colors.
Everything's abbreviated. Like C, like strength is C1, dexterity is C2, and endurance is C3. And then 4, 5, and 6 are your intelligence, your education, your social standing. But the reason why it's why everything is abbreviated in Traveler 5 is because it's just these are labels for everything. For humans, for alien races. So maybe for an alien race, it's not necessarily called strength. It might be called something else. You know, aliens might have different characteristics that humans don't even have, but they lump into the same category. So when you're making a character, making an alien, doing a skill check for your alien character, you just go along with these numbers rather than what they actually point to. That's part of the, what do they call that? That's the old system is setting. When you're playing a game like this and you're going through the system rules, you're actually going through the setting of the game as well. It's kind of interesting. You're sort of stuck in the game's setting when you're using the game's system. I like to detach those two things from each other and have, here's the game system, and then here's a game setting, and the two are apart from each other. but you can use the system rules in your setting. Instead of your setting rules being inside the system rules, if that makes sense.
And a difficulty check. And a normal difficulty check, I have.
So when a human goes to an alien world and the aliens say, "What is your C2 value?" They're asking, how dexterous are you? You puny human. How intelligent are you, puny human? What they're asking is, tell me about your C4. What value is your C4, stranger? You know, they don't talk. I mean, I'm making fun, obviously, but that's how the system, that's how the setting works. If you go too far with this, you know, everywhere you go in the setting, you've got this system baggage that you're dealing with constantly. So of course the players are going to talk out of character. Of course the players are going to ask questions, ask the referee questions constantly about things. Because this is like monolithic. Trailer 5 is monolithic rules. And it takes a while to digest. You have to decompress, depack, unpack. You have to unpack, decompress this information as you're reading it. And you have to read it a few times before you get the gist of what the rules are saying. So it takes a while. It takes a while for a human understanding of this Galaxian level of rules approach to role-playing.
Open a door. One cannot simply strain and strain and strain.
And a lot of the rules are optional, but you don't know that because they're not listed as optional. They're just in there. So it takes a really good referee to spot this and stop reading. When you see a rule, you should be able to think ahead, you know, 5 or 6 rules later that, oh, this is optional. I don't need to use this in the game. So I can just skip. A lot of Traveler 5 reading is skip. If you know what you're doing, if you're a decent referee, you can bypass a lot of the text in Traveler 5. It's not fluff. It's actually useful. You may come back to it later, realizing, oh, I'm gonna have to use that optional rule. I remember skipping over, you know, that kind of thing. Who is dragging a manhole cover across the street? And why? Hopefully you guys don't hear that.
Received load after all modifications. If burden does not exceed strength in kilograms, there is no penalty. Burden also detailed in the Krebs system chapter, which this is the first we're hearing of that.
Krebs. See, he takes a note. First time I'm hearing about Krebs. Sounds nasty having Krebs, but it's a thing in Traveler 5. But it's a Krebs is a measurement of equipment. You know, the quality, the reliability, how easy it is it to repair, how easy it is to use, understand, does it have a single use only, is it multi-use, that kind of thing. And it's all abbreviated into this Krebs thing. So everything in Traveler 5 has a Krebs rating. Your toothbrush, your toothpick, your Ziploc baggies, everything has a Krebs rating to it. So you can know how much it's worth, if it's been used, how much is it still worth, Can you sell it to somebody? Does somebody else find it interesting? It gets, you know, you're determining the value of something. I bought a Volkswagen. Volkswagen Bug, 1961. How much is it worth now? How much is it worth now to this alien race that has never seen one before? Maybe it's worth a hell of a lot of beans to them. Can you even get gasoline for the thing anymore? Did it come with a heater initially? Did it really have just one light bulb in its dashboard for all of its controls? What if that light bulb burns out? How do you see your dashboard at night? All these things go into the cribs.
Increase or decrease load carrying capacities, transferring loads, lifting, dragging, dexterity, grace.
He's been on that page for a while. Mongoose Traveler, you read the page about characteristics and about a paragraph or two and you're done. You're on to the next important thing in the game. But no, characteristics goes on for a whole chapter, I think, in Traveler 5. Anyway, enough of this. I'll put a link in the description below to this guy's channel if anyone's interested in Traveler 5. It's not a slow train wreck. It's not like a car accident that everyone wants to go rubberneck and look at. This is Traveler 5.1, which is actually playable. The rules work pretty much, except for one, which I might mention later in another video. But other than that, it's a great game for making your own role-playing game. I wouldn't say you want to play this game. You just want to use these rules to make your own game from scratch. And you pick the parts you need from Traveler 5 to do it. Anyway, talk to you later.